Hey everybody, it's Anna. Welcome to the Thursday card in this week's tarot story. So we have our third major arcana card for the week. It is the Emperor reversed. So the Emperor is the number four card in the major arcana. And the number four connects to balance, feeling anchored, and having a good foundation on which we can build. And so keeping that in mind, I always think of the Emperor as good father energy. The job of the good father is to create the household in which the children live. So that household is a private space. It's protected. It's got boundaries. It's got a door that can be locked. But it also has lots of space for the children to play. It's got toys and art supplies, and there's a garden, and anything a child needs to kind of expand and explore and get sort of anchored in their own identity before they go into the world. The world is the marketplace. We're not ready for the marketplace yet. We're still sort of in the Garden of Eden. I think of this as the Garden of Eden, the father who holds the Garden of Eden. So the Garden of Eden is protected by the father, established by the father. It's got everything in the world for the child to play and no danger. It's protected space. So when the card is upright, it suggests to me that we are in the middle of creating structures that are for our private space, a space for us to feel secure and safe and free to play. This card came to us reversed, and that suggests a couple of things to me. First of all, it suggests to me that the structures we're looking at are internal to us. We're not looking at, you know, building a studio or finding the right, you know, the right house necessarily. We are looking at internal structures. And the reversal also feels to me like it's a challenge for us to look at what structures, what internal structures we have that are currently not supporting us. Probably they've gotten too small for us, because that's how things work. You know, you have a house and then you outgrow the house. You have a structure, you outgrow the structure. That's the natural way of things, especially if you're a creative intuitive from the body or the heart. So chances are you have a structure that is old. Maybe it used to support you, but now it's too small and it's an internal structure. So what occurs to me is we've been talking this week about bringing into full consciousness our own magical nature. We are magical from the day we were born, maybe before the day we were born. We're magical already, but we don't always recognize it. So we are always a blessing. We're always evoking magic and doing interesting things. But for a time in our lives, our mind sort of isn't clued into that. It's not really paying attention. It doesn't know that's happening. So it's not part of the story. And what ends up happening is when it's time to expand or do something new, the mind, because it's not clued in on what we're doing, often will pull in the opposite direction. It gets worried. It gets nervous. It's worried, you know, it doesn't know what's going to happen next. It doesn't really understand the magic we are evoking. And so it's not a good partner to us. So this week is about, I think, it's about helping the mind get clearer and more on board with our real nature and our real calling on the planet, which is to get the mind to stop focusing on the problems, which it's sort of naturally designed to do. It's naturally designed to keep us alive, and it does that by identifying danger and solving danger. We're trying to get the mind to go beyond that, into envisioning what is possible, into understanding the magic we've already brought into the world, and to being open to what else is possible. So that means that the mind structures are probably set too small for what we're doing next. So if the mind says, okay, we want to have a job that's very stable because we need to make sure we have access to money. Because the mind believes that, you know, in order to do anything cool or fun, you have to earn it by working hard to make the money. That's actually a very common structure point. But if for you to make the money is going to take 3 years and you want to do something right now, so you want to expand right now. You don't want to put a condition on your expansion. You want to just magically move forward. So we have to get the mind to let go of a structure. That structure, like earn, you know, work your way through and earn some money before, that might've been very valuable and helpful before, but now you're ready to do something more magical, less linear. So we have to get the mind to release that. Now the mind's never going to say, oh yeah, we don't need money. Let's just run forward. Well, it might get there, but it's not likely for the mind to go straight from structure into total loosey-goosey freedom. But if you're helping the mind connect with the magic, the mind is seeing the evidence of the other times you've taken a leap of faith, you've had expansion. If you're letting the mind tell the story, like we talked about with the world yesterday, about you as the great hero, the hero of your story and the challenges you've received, if you're letting your mind enjoy the epic saga of your life and seeing yourself as the magical creature in the center of it, then your mind is more likely to say, okay, yeah, that structure, maybe we don't need it. Maybe I can release a little. The mind might still be uncomfortable with it, but you're asking it to try something new. So when we think of the mind as the good father, The job of the mind is to provide the right support system for us. That means if something is too small, it's the mind's job to tear it down and start over and build something bigger, build something that's resonant with what we are doing. So if you give the mind that task in that way, and the mind is already on board with recognizing that you are a magical, expansive, creative creature, and its job is to make that possible, the mind is less likely to buck at the shift and more likely to get on board and to ask what it can do to help. And that's what we're looking for. We're looking for the mind to be a good father energy and to help create the right structure, to tear down the old structure and create something new. So see what you can come up with. See you tomorrow for our last card. Bye.